Good day, ladies and gentlemen. The name is Busane Omosomohlekayise. And as you know, it's obviously that's a bit of a tongue twister. Just call me Troy. The name is Troy Malange. And today I have a very interesting young lady with me. Her name is Lerato. I know her as Lerato Kutu, but she's now a married woman. Lerato, do you mind just introducing yourself?
Good day, everyone. Thank you for having me, Busane.
Yebo.
I'm Lerato Kutu Agagba, and yeah. I'm a 25 years old, and I don't know what else you want to say.
Let me tell you a little about Lerato Kutu. Lerato Kutu is a young lady who's professionally trained as a fashion designer. If I may add, she was top of a class. How many distinctions did you get?
Well, let's not go into the numbers, but then I was top student like 2 years in a row.
So she comes from a fashion background, and you have decided to not go the root of being a fashion designer per se.
Talking about that, what actually happened is in my last year of my studies, when I was doing my BTEC, I realized that I didn't want to become a fashion designer in profession, but I was actually interested in becoming either a fashion buyer or planner, like the business side of fashion. And I applied for jobs, internship programs, and some graduate programs as well. Then, unfortunately, I ended up not getting any. So then I found myself at home and I'm thinking, what's going to happen? Because something needs to happen.
I can't be
sitting around. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so then I remembered one of the beach shops I knew as a child.
Okay.
Then I told my husband that I wanted to go visit one. Then eventually I got a chance, I went, and then I looked through what they had and picked up several materials, then took them home. When I got home, I started putting them together, and it seemed like, okay, girl, you are training yourself, or you are learning how to be making earrings in particular. Mm-hmm. Made several pieces, then shown them to my friends and my family members, and some of them were like, they were interested in buying. They started buying. Then I realized, you know what, maybe this is what I need to be doing.
That's a call.
Then I just ran with the idea, and I thought, you know what, it looks like I have something to give, a product to give, and looking at the response of the ladies I approached with my product, it was really promising and encouraging, and I thought to myself, maybe this could be it. So that's just how I landed into this business of earrings.
All right, just to give you a little background, Lerato has an Instagram and an online, is it an online thing, right?
An online store
selling earrings. So you can't be talking about, oh no, there's no employment and whatnot, when there's people like this who are so inspirational. She's also a child of God. You are Mamfundis.
Hey,
Suga. Yes. So I want to show you, she's gonna take us through her pieces that she has here, and I'll also put a couple of them on the screen to just show you what she's about, and we'll also put, you know, her Instagram account, and you can follow her and get yourself a good of, you know, local made earrings. Can you just take us through them, and please start with the ones you're wearing,
okay,
and tell us the motivation behind, you know?
The ones that I'm wearing, well, they are from a collection I called Boswa.
Okay.
And the collection was basically a collection made to celebrate our youthfulness.
Yeah.
It was a collection I made for June. I've decided to make earrings that are versatile, like they give you you can work with them with like almost a lot of design outfits, style, yeah, or outfits, yeah, exactly. So if you want to go some when they look at my earrings, they're like, oh, I can rock them with some traditional outfits and all that, and some they really just rock them on their day-to-day lady looking style, and some they rock them when they want to look extremely all girly, like,
yeah, yeah.
Sometimes really just look at the material I have, mm-hmm, and see what works with what, and then just draw designs,
yeah,
and put them together. Then when I'm done, I just look at them like, okay, I can see someone wearing this,
yeah,
and I can see someone looking at this and saying, this is lovely. Then that's how I basically sometimes come up with the with the idea of, yeah, the earrings. So yes, these ones, it's actually this month, August, mm-hmm, range yeah. For women.
Yeah.
I called it, I named it Bastardi, and I actually collaborated with a student from the University of Johannesburg. Mm-hmm. He's a BTEC student.
Yeah.
His name is Nguli, and we just came up with designs for this month to celebrate women. Mm-hmm. And this is one of the ideas and the pieces we came out with from the collaboration. So I do also cater for a little bit of your preference.
So you do customize for your customers depending on what they want.
If you prefer them short, then you can have them short. If you want them long, you can have them long and in the color that you prefer.
Wonderful. So Lerato, just in closing, do you mind just telling us, like you from, you know, your experience as an upcoming young lady in business, what is the message that you have for every young person out there who's maybe not finding the job they want, or they're stuck in a job that they really are not enjoying and they want to venture into business but they're a bit scared? What advice do you have for them?
Really, there is a lot that we can do. I feel like there is a lot that we can do, and we cannot afford to be sitting and allowing people to just pity us and having pity parties about the fact that we're not up to anything. I feel like there's a lot, and even if it means doing something without being paid for it, I feel like there's a lot that these little things do to you as a person.
The experience they give
exactly the experience they give you. They mold you. I was talking to you earlier. I was telling you that I feel like at this age we're living in right now, it's a time for the grinding. It's a time for putting in the work.
Sure.
Put in the work without, you know what, even if it looks like you, at some point it will feel like you don't know what you're doing, but then just go on with it. It's the time to be putting in the work.
Indeed.
Because the years are coming where you probably won't have the strength.
Yeah.
It was sad when I went through the rejection of not being able to get into a job I wanted. It was sad, but then looking back, I'm like, I feel like it had to happen.
Yeah,
I feel like I had to go through that so that I can realize my fullest potential. Because if I got the job, I can tell you, like, I can assure you, I wouldn't have started this.
Okay, there's no better way to conclude this. She has said it in not so many ways that you have to just wake up and do it yourself. You know, no, don't expect people to come and give you, present opportunities to you. You can just, you know, be out here and put your little foot and do what you're supposed to do. Ladies and gentlemen, that is our cover story for this month from the inspirational Lerato, a fashion designer turned earring designer. Very, very, very powerful young lady indeed. Kanet, you can always see that, you know, this is a Mamfundis. You know, it's there. Even when she speaks, you can just pick it up. So for me, this is PR, Plastic Revolution, and it's peace out and adios. And thank you for coming, Lerato.
Thank you for having me.